Thank you very much, Judge.
He's the former underdog who is now a big dog, the leader of the pack as far as true conservative principles go, and tied for first in some of the polls in Iowa. Texas Congressman Ron Paul's new ad says his fellow candidates Mitt Romney and Newt Gingrich have more bark than bite when it comes to limiting the size of the government. Take a listen to this.
You want big cuts. Ron Paul's been screaming it for years. Budget crisis, no problem. Cut $1 trillion year one. That's trillion with a T. Department of Education, gone. Interior, Energy, HUD, Commerce, gone. Later, bureaucrats. That's how Ron Paul rolls. Want to drain the swamp? Ron Paul, do it.
Just do it. Joining me now is the man who's bringing the fight to the lapdogs for big government. Texas Republican Congressman Ron Paul. Congressman Paul, as always, it's a pleasure. Welcome back to Freedom Watch.
Thank you, Judge.
How do you explain the shift in the polls as to who's up, who's down, and now what appears to be movement toward Newt Gingrich, who has far, far more in common with Barack Obama than he does with true small government values, the values that you've been preaching?
You know, if we hadn't just gone through 6 months of a flavor of the month or the flavor of the week, I would think that, you know, this is for real. But I don't know if this surge for Newt is real. It doesn't seem to be to me that it really is. It seems like the people aren't paying a lot of attention. And when they do, they have a superficial opinion about somebody. And whoever's had the most news in the last news cycle seems to get the most attention. So I think it's too early to tell. But also, I think when Cain dropped out, those individuals went someplace else, and they have gone over to Newt. But I think as they look more carefully at Newt, and as you have and mentioned about his alliance with progressivism of Theodore Roosevelt, you know, I think conservatives are going to have to take a more careful look.
Isn't it ironic that in the same day, at almost the exact same time, that President Obama was speaking in a small rural town in Kansas that hasn't voted for a Republican for president in over 100 years, identifying himself with Theodore Roosevelt? Newt Gingrich was on Glenn Beck's radio show identifying himself with Theodore Roosevelt. Could you imagine if these two guys actually identified with the same big government hero when in fact they do?
Well, you know, those of us that sometimes think there's planning and the scheming between the two parties, so there's no difference. They, you know, those who love the Fed and they love the foreign policy and they love the welfare, you know, they're satisfied with both candidates. But that's supposed to be a secret conspiracy theory, but now it's sort of out in the open. You know, there's two people that would have outwardly and openly supporting their same hero. So I would say it should be a strong message to the American people, because the message I'm hearing from the American people and the demonstrations on our streets is they're sick and tired of what they're having and the status quo, and they're certainly not going to find an answer just by supporting somebody who has very similar views to our president.
You mentioned the Fed. Ben Bernanke today claims that we should have known all along about the unbelievable amounts of money that he was funneling to American banks and to foreign banks while the Congress was voting for TARP and stimulus packages. As a result of a lawsuit filed by Fox Business and by our colleagues at Bloomberg News, we discover the number was $7.7 trillion in the eight-month period from September 08 to April 09. Now, Chairman Bernanke says, well, you shouldn't have been surprised about it. We briefed members of Congress on it. Were you briefed on this? Were you told how much money the Fed was printing and distributing while the Congress was borrowing money and giving it to the same banks?
No, and I was very suspect. I assumed they were doing this all along. So even with my skepticism of what the Fed does and what they don't tell us, you know, it still was a little bit shocking to me to find the amount, because there are other numbers that are actually even bigger than the $7 trillion. If you go over a broader period of time, there might be well over $15 trillion of credit that they were churning in and out of domestic banks as well as foreign banks. So it's a big operation. For him to indicate that we should have known and he gave us that information, that's stretching it, I'll tell you.
Congressman Paul, it's a pleasure. Thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you, Judge.